Hello dear viewers and welcome to today's video. Bacopa monnieri, also called Brahmi, is a most amazing plant. Bacopa monnieri belongs to the genus Bacopa. It was first described by the French botanist and physician Louis-Guillaume Le Monnier, hence its euphonious name. The plant is also known by the names water hyssop or Indian pennywort. Naturally, this plant grows in the tropical areas of our planet, especially in Africa and Asia, where it is also cultivated as a medical plant due to its amazing effects. Brahmi has been used in Ayurvedic medicine since ancient times. It finds mention in the Charakara Samhita, the oldest surviving medical work in India. Respect for the plant is reflected in the word Brahmi, as this refers to Brahma, the god of creation, who is associated with every form of creativity in Indian culture. Brahmi is also used in traditional Chinese medicine. The plant can be used fresh in cooking, but it has a bitter taste. It can also be dried and then wonderfully added to yogurt or curd, for example. Smoothies can also be perfectly enhanced with it. But it's best to take specially concentrated supplements in order to achieve the highest yield of valuable ingredients. Responsible for the outstanding effect of the otherwise quite inconspicuous small plant is its high content of various secondary plant compounds. These are compounds that are not vital to the plant and are only found in certain types of cells, in contrast to primary plant compounds. Primary plant substances, on the other hand, are those that are directly involved in metabolism or cell construction. As in animal organisms, these are, for example, fats, proteins, and carbohydrates. In other words, everything that makes plant nutritious for us. Chlorophyll, the substance that is essential for plant energy production from sunlight, is also part of this. On the other hand, there are the secondary plant substances of phytochemicals. The best known are caffeine from the coffee plant and nicotine from tobacco. Brahmi contains several very interesting substances, including bacillocyte A and B, luteolin, and epigenin, the alkaloid bramine, and phytosterols. Below we show you some of the amazing, scientifically proven effects of this plant. Number 1. The plant protects against cancer. Free radicals triggered by oxidative stress can cause inflammatory processes and thus cancer. According to an analysis of various studies, Brahmi, with its rich antioxidants, can neutralize these radicals. In vitro studies show effects on breast cancer, colon cancer, and brain tumors. Second, the plant protects against Alzheimer's disease. When free radicals react with fat in the brain, the fat can oxidize, leading to a process called lipid peroxidation. This can trigger Alzheimer's, Parkinson, and other neurodegenerative diseases by causing waste deposits in the brain, which intervene with the neuron's normal function. The numerous antioxidants in Brahmi may also help prevent this. A study on rats with Brahmi confirms this. Third, the plant stimulates your brain function. Various experiments on animals and on humans confirm that Brahmi can improve memory performance. After taking 300 mg of Brahmi daily for several weeks, 46 healthy test subjects were better able to remember newly learned material and process visual information faster than a placebo group. This effect lasted for 12 weeks. Individuals over 60 who took 300 to 600 mg of Brahmi also showed improved brain performance in another study. Fourth, Brahmi alleviates anxiety and depression. Brahmi works on rats similarly to anxiety-reducing psychotropic drugs in the benzodiazepine group. It calms without similar side effects, such as a high potential for addiction or disruption of memory function. Another study in humans also demonstrated this effect. Fifth, Brahmi alleviates symptoms of ADHD. An Indian study of 31 children with ADHD, that is attention deficit or hyperactivity disorder, between 6 and 12, took 225 milligrams of Brahmi daily for 6 months showed improvement in ADHD symptoms. Restlessness, concentration and learning difficulties, and impulsivity each improved in 67 to 93% of the children. In comparison, commercially available medications hit an average of 70% of children, and that is coming with a lot of side effects. Have you heard of this amazing plant? Have you tried it? Please share your experiences with us in the comments below. We're looking forward to seeing you soon again.